Okay, everyone, I'm gonna talk about set cookie and I'm gonna show some examples here. So this is the concept that I was assigned to talk about is set cookie, and the name is very self-explanatory. We're gonna set a cookie, we're gonna create a cookie, and it's just a function that accepts some arguments here. It has the name of the cookie, or the name of the index in the array, the value. It can be a token, it can be a number, it can be a string, it can be a boolean, it can be any value here. The expiration time, like for how long we want to keep that cookie alive, and then the path, like where in the server this cookie can be accessed, and the domain is a where in the domain, in the URL. Yeah, so this one is about the server and this one is about the URL. So both, like, all the options, all the values are optional here. And secure if it's through HTTPS only, and this one is an extra value. So since I don't have a lot of time, I'm gonna go ahead and explain what I've done, the test or the example that I've prepared for this. So, but I would like to emphasize this a little bit more. And to do that, I created this. So, for example, let's say that this is our folder structure. So we have a root and index file here, and then we have more folders, and those folders have more folders. So if I define the path of the cookie like this, that means that all the files in the server are gonna have access to that cookie. But if I move that file, the path a little bit down, for example, shopping, that means that only these files are gonna have access to that shopping, to that cookie. So okay, since we have a lot of time, I'm gonna bring the screen over. So I prepared, let me check the time. Okay, so I prepared this document. I have three files: index.php, I have print.php, and destroyer.php. And in the index.php file, I'm setting the cookie. So I'm getting an action. I'm gonna explain that later. And then I'm setting a cookie, and that's gonna live only for a day. And then I'm printing the value of the cookie. And then that's for the destroyer. When if I destroy the cookie, that message is gonna be printed. And then I have just for 10 testing purposes, I have two more links that allows me to go from the index to the printer to see the value of the cookie, from the index to the destroyer to destroy the cookie. So the printer is super simple. I just have I just count how many cookies are in that cookie and that array. So if the value is greater than zero, so that means that there is a cookie, and probably my cookie ABC should be there. If not, I print this message. And the destroyer is just like, that's the same, like checks if there is a cookie, and then prints the value of the cookie, and then like destroys the cookie. So there's no way to destroy the cookies, you set the time to the past. So like, so it means that it expired already. So, and I'm gonna explain more that, like, if you want to look at the code, just pass the video and go there. So when I load this URL, I set the cookie, that's the name, the value, this is the value of my cookie. If I go to the printer, this is a different file, so I can see the value of the cookie. But if I go back to the index, and then I go to the destroyer, I can print the cookie, and then I destroy the cookie, and after the cookie was destroyed, I can go to the index. So since the cookie was destroyed, I can't access it. So if I go to the printer again, the same. I can't access it because it was destroyed. So, but if I reload the page, if I go to the printer, I can see the printer here. So if I go back to the destroyer and then here, that cookie is gone. So I hope that it was helpful. And if you wanna take a look at the code, just pause the video and copy the, I can post it. I can upload the code if you guys need. So let me know if it was helpful. Thank you.